Dear friends, welcome today in the Facebook stream. We are going to talk about menopause, as I announced in the video before. There is a question many times from many women between the age of, say, 40 and 60 who have questions about these kind of things. And you have to understand that this is a problem that is prevalent in almost all societies in one form or another, but in some societies more than others. I have already made a little bit of notes because of the app I'm building on Wudang Fitness and Wudang Kung Fu and on nourishment and instructor courses. I have the opportunity to create a good teaching environment, and from here we are going to talk about some things which is going to be more helpful for the Facebook streams also, because you know I can explain a little bit more. Hopefully I can also do the Friday evening streams from here very soon. I am preparing the space for that purpose, but we are not that far yet. At the moment when we are doing this at this point, you have to understand that menopause is something that is a problem that is not specific for men, although men complain about it in comedy and so on, but it is a problem that belongs to women. And it has to do with the fact that women for their whole life are all the time preparing to get pregnant. And because of our lifestyles, women go through particular kind of changes that men don't suffer. In a sort of half-joking way, in Chinese medicine we say, okay, when a woman is born, she is a child and she is without a gender. Like a boys also, they are without a gender. But at the moment when they grow older and they start bleeding, they are trying to get pregnant. At the moment when society spits them out, they forget being a woman and they become like a man. And that means that men are basically spit out biological creatures, and we have very little real function. And in that sense, you can say that the peak of human evolution is in womanhood. But the thing is that this quality of being the peak of human evolution comes with a disadvantage, namely that every month you go through particular kind of hormonal and physiological changes, which keeps your body adaptive. That is a very important quality for your health qualities compared to that of men. But as a result of that, at a certain point your body reaches, because of our lifestyle and so on, a particular kind of a point where it doesn't function as good anymore, and then you gradually start developing a what is called a delayed menstruation. Delayed menstruation can take place all over your life, and there are many Chinese medicine classics already from the 2nd century AD which write specifically only about this kind of topics, and it is a long subject and it takes a long time to study this properly, to understand what is actually going on. And it is also why I'm always very happy when people come with fertility problems or menopause problems, because it is really something you have to put your teeth in to really resolve this. So when you watch this session, I'm not going to promise you to resolve this problem for you, but I'm promising you that you can have some things you can try and exercise and practice to help you overcome this problem. You have to understand a little bit about the background of this problem. So this is why I wrote down the whiteboard here for you as a few notes, as a reminder. And I don't know if you can read it or if it is in mirror image, because in my screen I see it in mirror image, and I see this in like I said, on the wrong side of the glass. But in general you can say that according to Chinese medicine, menopause should not happen. That means compared to our biology, we know from anatomical research that when menopause starts, women could still produce a lot of follicles for pregnancy. But because of lifestyle, and this is what the Huang Ni Jing already said 2600 years ago, because of lifestyle we forget actually be healthy, and as a result of that we start aging, getting diseases, and we die. So in general you can say the reason why you have menopause is because of a wrong lifestyle according to Chinese medicine. That is very important to know. In Chinese medicine it says that if you have a right lifestyle you would not die. To figure out what is the right lifestyle though is not an easy task, I can tell you that. Look at my wrinkles, it is not the easiest part. I am still learning also as anybody else. But in your lifestyle, if your lifestyle causes aging, then there are a few things that we know of that are definitely causing you problems. That is eating greasy food, and a lot of people, they eat fried food at least a few times a week. and in that sense, greasy, fried, turbid stuffs are not very good for your health. And that is, of course, a poor diet in general is very bad. A poor diet means both basically processed foods. So everything that is processed, like smoothies and things from a pot or from a tin or from a bag or from a restaurant, all these kind of things are usually not really very healthy. When you eat outside your climate, when you eat outside your area, and so on, not very very good. So at this moment, I'm of course making advertisement for your local farmers. And I would go to the local farms and go get there your food if you can, or grow it yourself. Like I'm trying to grow something in my garden. My garden is not big enough to suffice for my whole family, but it is great to eat something from your own garden. We had salad yesterday evening from the garden, and the children immediately recognized, like, hey, this is food that is actually better than what we get from the supermarket. And they say this, yeah, they notice this. What is very important is that when you have delayed menses, when you have menopause syndrome, which I just categorize for you under the category of delayed menses, what is being reduced is called the Tian Gui, and you can say that this is your allotment of heaven. And that means that we are born prenatally with a particular kind of potential, namely the potential to become immortal. And at the moment when we waste that because of our lifestyle, then the Tian Gui becomes less. And that means that our Yuan Qi, the prime potential for living forever, becomes reduced because it becomes less accessible to us. It doesn't really reduce anything because the universe doesn't really care about us that much. That it would allot us a particular kind of amount. It's not a bureaucratic or anything like that. It is just that you have the potential as a human being, when you are being spit out by a mom on the floor, to become an immortal. And it is up to you to actually become that. Of course, it's also up to our parents, which have to give us the right kind of education to have a chance to become an immortal. So at the moment when you look at the Yuan Qi separates itself in the yin and the yang qi, and the yin qi is both your water and your physical body, and the yang qi is your activity and the warmth of your body at the same time. And this is also the reason why you experience such strange symptoms as heat flush, sometimes dizziness, maybe flowery vision, headaches, tiredness. There's a whole bunch of symptoms that you probably know yourself best when you have menopause. So to reduce this, we have to come to an understanding of how to resolve these kind of things. So let's first start with a few exercises before our time is finished. I spent 10 minutes talking to explain you this thing, and I think that is more than enough. Hi, Peter. I hope your menopause is not a problem to you. That's a man, so I don't think so. I made a list here of exercises we're going to go through. We have to see how far we go. And the first one is pull the lower back to like a turtle. So I'm going to make a little bit more space here to make sure that you can see what I am doing at that moment. And at the moment when we are exercising this practice, let's make a little bit more space. I cannot really see the bottom part of my screen here, and it has to do with several factors. One of them is the fact that this is a Samsung telephone. If Samsung would give me this phone for free for my work, I would probably not make that compliment of them to them. Complaint, yes. But the reality is that, like any other phone, they're just a form of mind pollution. Okay, when we do this exercise, first make sure you bring your arms up and you create a strong fist. You bring your elbows down and you pull your lower arm tight. You pull your lower arm tight and you push your elbows up so that your arms go under your armpit, and you push up. You keep your fists tight and you push them up. And then you relax your hands, relax completely, bend through your knees and come up, vertebra after vertebra until you're standing straight. So shall I do this from the side? At the moment when we do this exercise, lift up, squeeze hard, pull down. And at the moment when you pull down under your armpits, turn your fist, push up, so that you stretch up your lower back
And then relax, rotate, hang out, bend to the knees, and slowly
come up. So if you do this every day, you will see that your lower back actually is going to be stretched, and as a result of that, your kidneys also create more space, and as a result of that, they can function better. That is a very important part in Chinese medicine in general. They say if the kidneys have enough space, then a lot of life functions will be better in general. So this is a good practice, period, even if you have no menopause syndrome. So this is a great practice to wake up with, especially in the winter when you get more cold, because it warms up your kidneys also. So let's go to the second exercise. This is connect the kidneys to heaven. And for this is actually a very simple exercise. I go sit for that. I hope you can still listen to me. And what you want to do is you want to imagine the dark evening sky above you. And the dark evening sky has the, how do you say, the Big and the Small Dipper, and the Draco's in the center or between them. And then next to the Dipper, there is the polar star, and next to the polar star, there is this disappearance point where Chinese culture says this is where the universe starts. At the moment, when you look at the sky, you see that the world is actually like a spiral. It's spiraling outward, and this spiral outward we call the Milky Way. This is the yellow road according to Chinese mythology. So they don't talk about it as a Milky Way. The Milky Way, that has probably has to do with the fact that we have an overproduction of milk still in the world, which, as you know, creates osteoporosis. So do not drink too much milk. Very important. At the moment when you're sitting like this, just relax and feel this space above you. But what is very important to understand is that the color of the sky, according to the Taoists, is not black, but it is purple. So feel that from this disappearance point around the polar star, actually a purple light is radiating outward, and this gradually is enveloping you. And when you breathe it into your body, and you feel how it is entering your kidneys and your dantian. And the kidneys get strengthened, and does do a lot of things. It helps you to open up your spinal column, to become more warm, but also to become more calm, so that your belly actually starts relaxing, and it creates all kinds of natural opiates, which makes you feel very good. And as a result of that, one of the functions of the kidneys is to regulate your menstrual cycle, so that your belly finds peace, your uterus finds peace, and your follicle production machinery also finds peace. It actually takes away some of the stress which has to regulate your kidney functions. At the moment when you sit like that, you can sit like that for a long time if you want. You can keep your eyes open so that you don't fall asleep. And as a result of that, you will start slowly adjust yourself to a more calm lifestyle, which is of course always very good, because when you live a calm lifestyle, you have more vitality. When you are stressed and you're hyperactive, of course you exhaust your kidneys, you exhaust the yang and the yin of your body, and as a result that you make wrong decisions, like doing very strong fitness and make very big muscles or something like this, where you go running or bicycling very fast, or you do extreme sports, so that you continuously subject your kidneys to what is called fear. And in Chinese medicine we say everything that causes stress and fear scatters the kidney qi, and as a result that the yin and the yang are broken, and as a result that your body becomes very unhealthy. So this is the reason why Taoists always emphasize a natural and a calm lifestyle. So at this moment, when you're doing this, actually you're busy working on a calm and relaxed lifestyle. So it is not that the purple light or anything has any healing qualities. It just helps you to create a particular kind of quality of life. And make sure that you are aware of the fact that if you visualize all these things, it's not effective compared to when you really feel it like to be like that. And it is the same like what they talk about in Buddhist tantrism and in Taoist tantrism. When you are practicing something, affirmation is a way of saying like, this is what I want to do. Visualization is making visible what you're going to do, but it has to become real before it actually really does something. So that means you need time to practice. A visualization of an affirmation, in general, they are not effective, but they are a good start. Then we are going to work on the nourishment of the Dantian. And because we talk about the yang and the yin, we actually talk about the umbilicus. And what we do is we put the left hand and the right hand on each other, and that means, I'll put you a little bit closer so it doesn't look so far away. Can you still see me? Can you see my Dantian? No, you cannot. So I have to make the standard a little bit lower. Yep, almost. It's so funny to do a stream like this and then continuously have to adapt all your equipment to make sure that everything goes all right. I feel like I do 5 jobs at the same time, and I understand why people sometimes work in a team, but if you work in a team, everything becomes more expensive. And of course, as a good Taoist practice, you try to spend as little money as possible on things so that you have a peace of mind because of not getting yourself into financial trouble. Anyway, you put your Lao Gong points on each other and you cross the hands and you put them on your umbilicus so that the Lao Gong points actually are following the umbilicus. The umbilicus is straight behind Ming Men, and it is between the kidneys. So you feel there's a line between the Lao Gong points, Ming Men, and the Dantian. And at the moment when you feel this line, you can feel this line is gradually warming up, and it's also warming up your kidneys, but it's also moistening your kidneys at the same time. It's nourishing both the yin and the yang. So we sit like this for a while, keep your arms relaxed, your shoulders relaxed, keep your arm, your body up. You can even imagine yourself to sit in the purple light of heaven that we talked about before. Normally it would be good to sit like this for about 20 minutes a day, 25, 30 even better. Make sure you don't sit too short, and it's the same with the purple light. Make sure you don't sit too short, so combining the two maybe is a good idea. If you sit too short, it doesn't really work very much. Your body needs to grow, your mind needs to grow, and it needs time for that. Healing as such is a very slow process. The whole biology of human beings is all very slow processes. It's a little bit like watching the grass grow and watching the trees grow. Over time you see the growth, but at the moment when you're looking, it all looks very still and motionless. So keep your attention in your belly. And keep the tongue against the palate. So the tip of the tongue against the palate, so that you can moisten your mouth and you can feel the saliva being produced, and swallow the saliva and feel how the saliva moves all the way to below your palms into the Dantian area. If you feel your mouth is too dry, you can move your tongue around your teeth and the bottom of your tongue to produce more saliva. You can clap your teeth also to help you produce more saliva. Same. You have to understand that a lot of practices, they are bingo practices. That means that you do them in the hope that it goes well. Because I don't know your personal situation, of course, from this video, it is important to realize that every exercise is an experiment to see if it works for you or not. Qigong is not a guaranteed success. There is often a need for a lot of adaptation. That is why every practitioner of Qigong has to study Chinese medicine at a certain point. So if you feel like, just sign up for the courses to learn at least the basic theories so that you have an understanding of what is what. At the moment when you sit for some time, you start noticing changes in your body starts feeling more comfortable. And as a result of that, you start feeling as if the sun starts shining inside you, and also the moon starts shining inside you at the same time. And this is palpable in your eyes and in your face and in your whole body, as if your body is starting to radiate a little bit of light on the inside. And that feeling actually is pretty nice and is a good contrast to what you normally feel during menopause attack. The nourishing of the yin and the yang. Of course, when the yin and the yang are properly nourished, you always feel great about yourself. If you don't feel that good, then that might actually mean that you can use some yin-yang nourishment. So then do this exercise too. It's also very good against depression, against circulation problems in general, because the dantian is the engine that makes the qi and the blood circulate inside your body. You have to understand that Qigong is not like driving a car. You know what is the map and you have to go just drive the car along that road and then you get there. Actually, it's a little bit more complicated than that. It's more like trekking. I don't know if you know what is trekking, but trekking means that you have to go through a landscape that you hardly know and then you have to find a way how it works. This is why it's very hard to follow anybody's advice, as you already know. That is why people very often complain about therapists that they're not very successful, because they don't understand the concept of tracking. They work according to formulas and standardized programs, and standardized programs work in generally okay, but you only have like 40 to 60% success. But what you need is 100% success, of course, and it means that you really need a good understanding. Okay, so when you have done that for a long time, we have to take care of our time also. At that moment, you have to understand that there is a song that you can sing, and it is called the Chui song, and it is not the Chui song from my Korean family, but it is the Chui song from intending to say Chui, and then the pressure that you make at the moment that you intend to say that, you put towards your kidneys, so that you actually try to grow your kidneys and to try to nourish them. So it means that you make a little bit of a low back, a rounded back, at the moment you do it as if you're sitting on the toilet. And at the moment when you do that, you make the feeling in yourself as if you say chui, and then you go to tsh, and you when you breathe out. So you press as if you make the sound, but you don't really make the sound, like you see with people when they make the healing sounds, they say these words. It's the same like saying like wealth, and then you become all of a sudden very rich. It doesn't really work like that. It's just naive if you think like that. So, but it is a pressure method, the five healing sounds according to Hua Tuo and other thinkers from the past. And nobody really knows how they did it in the past, but this is the method that I learned from one of my Taoist masters. And when they teach me this, it goes like, so you really put pressure on your kidneys and you make a little bit round so that you really bring the pressure towards your kidneys. That means you keep your tongue against your palate, you don't really say it, but you intend to say it. And use the pressure to bring to your kidneys. My kidneys always become nice and comfortably warm, and after that I feel my body starts cleaning very much and feels much better. And when I now sit straight, even after only doing this three times, I already feel immediately my body circulation has improved, because my kidneys are filtering my blood immediately a lot better. It takes a lot of time of practice before you actually have that same kind of benefits, this is basically the root of these kind of practices. You have to understand that what you normally learn about these kind of things, practices in the West, is simplified by our Western ignorance, you can say, where we don't really understand the things from another culture. We try to fill it in with concepts of our own culture, and we have this strange notion of thinking that if you say a particular word, that is the same as a word. That is also why we tend to believe people sometimes either in the social or the political climate, or in our relationships or in our friendships. And then at a certain point you get disappointed, which of course causes a kind of stress, which causes you to eat greasy food, start going to the snack bar and eat bad quality food, or buy things in the supermarket on the wrong basis, namely, for instance, because you went shopping when you were hungry, which doesn't make you make the right choices. And before you say like, yeah, this guy always knows better, everybody makes the wrong choices by time. So it is a matter of thinking forward about your life. People tend to think a lot, but they think usually about the past. And because they think about the past, they feel bad about all these kind of things, but they don't really plan for the future. So we think about the future in the sense of worrying about our future, but we don't really think about what we can do to prevent that we have to worry. And the thing is, menopause is best, of course, when you're 25, to start thinking about what you can do to make sure that your menopause has as little impact as possible. And that means changing your lifestyle. I hope this video was very nice for you. And if you really enjoy this video, give it a like. If you're not my friend yet, then become my friend. That will be very good for me and also for you. I'm going to put this video also on YouTube. And I'm collecting these videos, of course, within my Facebook page for you to look back at later. So when you're a friend, you can easily find me and look back into the archive that we're slowly building with these kind of things. And as a result of that, you every time when you come across a problem, you can use it as a reference to make sure that you can deal with things in a better way. Or at least can learn to think about it. There are some gems in there. There's also some things that maybe are not so useful to you, but perhaps you know people who would be interested, and share these things with you, or share even this channel with you. We're very soon going to change these kind of things because there's a Dowland page that is now being produced, and we are going to gradually start doing these streams from this Dowland page, and then that means that things are going to be more formally connected with it. That is also because their new batch, the first batch of the instructors from the new Dowland Health Builder app is going to be ready within a few months' time. They are getting ready to start giving their own classes, and they will start making promotions for these classes also on this app. So I hope that you also share this, of course, for them, because they are also going to be the ones that, once they are going further and maybe graduate from the bachelor or the master program, are going to sit here with me or instead of me, or not maybe not in this place, but in a similar place in their own environment. And they are going to also give you sessions and classes, in the hope that we can every day provide everybody with information for free as a service for basic healthcare, of course, because healthcare as a moral thing, which is something that humanity shares with each other as a need, healthcare should always be free as much as possible. Of course, to be free, we have to have a non-monetary economy. So think about what you can do in your environment to have a non-monetary economy. And that doesn't mean that everything has to go through credit cards, but that we have to come to a more socially valid society, so that we don't have to start earning money all the time. Because every time when you see people start earning money, they tend to lose their morality that they had when they had nothing, and they start exploiting their environment to get more, and that is a little bit of a pity. That's why in Taoism they say money is the biggest stress, and as a result of that people get all kinds of diseases and they forget all kinds of things. As a result they age and they die. Alright, so thank you for listening to my positive response today about life. Sorry for laughing about myself, but I always think it's very funny. That is basically the message of Chinese medicine, and I happen to be very fond of Chinese medicine, Taoist medicine. And I see that a lot of people, they practice Chinese medicine nowadays on a very bookish way. They learn this on their schools, and they treat as a result of that diseases in a very symptomatic and systematic way, according to all kind of formulas, without actually having a clear understanding. They know all the mechanics and they know all the stories, but in clinic it always works out a little bit different. Enjoy the practice. Let me know also if you have any benefits from these practices. Usually within a few weeks' time you should start noticing a little bit of changes. Menopause can take a few years before you're through it, but if it helps you to mitigate the effects of the menopause, then that would be really great, and it would be great news for the people below it, because that gives them of course a good foundation to also practice these kind of things. Success! And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them. And see you next week. Next week we're going to practice some Tai Chi Chuan, by the way, in case you are interested, or in case you know people who are interested. We're going to show how Tai Chi Chuan actually is used for your health and why it works like that. And Friday evening, that is in 2 days' time. And now it's, for me, it's Wednesday morning, so Friday evening we do another session. Usually it takes about 1.5 hours, sometimes 2 hours. Last time went 2 hours. And then I answer all kind of questions, or I come sometimes with suggestions for topics myself. And this time also we have a few questions that people want answers for. And it can be like a health practice, medicine, and so forth and so forth. If people have questions about particular kind of exercises, we can work on that as well. So again, it's hard to say goodbye.